Friends, welcome back to my channel. In last video, I modified this Xbox power supply. While modification, I removed these 330 microfarad capacitors, 200 volt range, and I installed 180 and 120 microfarad capacitor. So now it is 180 microfarad plus 120. It is now 300 microfarad. I received comments from my viewers . There are many questions. My viewer Dontronics, he said, quick question, the 2x330 microfarad 200 volt were in series, so why did not you reuse them? Effectively they will be 160 microfarad at 400 volt. Then Luca Fras, he says same question. Then there is a discussion with my viewers. I don't think the capacitors should have been removed. Can you explain why they were replaced? Yes, we will see. There is a discussion between my viewers. Then there is another question, why is it not converting 110 volt power supply to 220 volt? The secondary side of the power supply voltage does not increase but remain the same. Could you explain, tell me? First of all, we will analyze this circuit and then I will explain my opinion, my idea. And it is my own opinion, own analysis. Maybe you will agree or not. If you have agree, please let me know. If you don't agree, kindly write in the comments. So maybe it will helpful addition for me. We will not see the circuit in this way. We will see the circuit some different ways. This line, after passing these safeties, it is reaching to center terminal of the capacitors. I will place two capacitors here. Negative, positive. Positive, negative. It is the same configuration. Now we have this line here, this line is reaching here, and the same line it will reach here. Because this line, it was connected to both AC input terminals. I think it will now easy to understand the circuit. This is negative out, this is positive out. This time we have 110 volt input. We are charging this capacitor and this capacitor. These are now not in series, because we are using this rectifier to apply positive voltage and this rectifier to positive voltage, and this one to the negative voltage and this one to the negative voltage. This is our signal at this line. The opposite signal we are providing here. And if we see, if it is 60 hertz signal or 50 hertz, we will consider it 60 hertz. We will provide this time to charge this capacitor. The same way, the second capacitor will charge in the same time. Charge, and then it will charge again in this period. But when we use in bridge rectifier, at that time, the capacitor size will decrease. This time we are using 330 microfarad capacitor. 330 microfarad capacitor. 200 volt. But if we see, this capacitor will charge also at the same voltage, 110 volt. We will cover both questions in the same time. Here we are applying 110 volt RMS. Take peak voltage. It is 155 volts DC for this capacitor and 155 volt for this capacitor. We can say this capacitor will charge at 155 and this will charge at 155. And if you will measure the voltage here, it will equal to 311 volts. Total 311 volts. It is the answer for our second question that we are increasing the input voltage. Why the output is not increasing? The output will not increase. We will see it now. So both capacitors will provide 311 volts. This time, if we see, this capacitor will allow to flow the current from positive terminal to this side and the second capacitor. So this will provide 330 microfarad capacitor in one line and this one in second line. And there is no any series connection because this line will allow to charge these capacitors one by one at positive half cycle and negative half cycle. But when we will modify it, when we use this configuration of the bridge rectifier, here both AC input terminals were connected to the same line. But here the bridge rectifier is working as a bridge rectifier. Here it was working as a full wave rectifier. But now 220 volt in the output here, why I used one capacitor? It is now 180 and 120, it is 300 microfarad, 400 volt. Two capacitors in parallel. And now, if we see 220 multiply with 1.414, 311 volts. So we will receive 311 volt. The same here. This one or this one. Now the question, why I did not use two capacitors in series? What is the reason? 330 microfarad 200 volt, 330 microfarad 200 volt. When we will connect in series, the total capacitance will decrease. 330 divided by 2. 330 microfarad divided by 2, 165 microfarad. If we will use two capacitors in series, now we will see in some different angle. We are charging from rectified AC voltage here. In charging process, this circuit, these capacitors will charge easily, okay, no problem. But when we are using at high frequency, because it have to handle two type of currents. Here we have high frequency switching that will use high current. At that time, when we have high frequency switching, a small amount of wire that will cause to create stray inductance. are parasitic inductance. So if you look this capacitor, it have its own capacitive reactance, and this one it have also its own capacitive reactance. And this connector now, it will also become an inductor. It will also behave as a resistor, because at that time we will use this positive terminal and this negative terminal. So this connection, it will also cause to create inductance in the circuit. We know the inductance value in the circuit, that will cause to drop the efficiency at high frequency when the source resistance is increased, and also this will not provide enough current to the load. Okay, this will work, no problem. But in this condition, when we are using one capacitor, there is no more stray inductance here. The second thing, here it was using one series ESR, equivalent series resistor, but when we will use here two capacitors, these have their ESR value, so this ESR value will also doubled. When it is doubled and we have an inductor here, so it will all cause to drop the efficiency of the circuit. So this is the reason I use one capacitor. We can use this configuration as well. So this series configuration can also be a cause to decrease the efficiency, and it will cause early failure of the capacitors. So the question from one of my viewer, that why the voltage are not doubled. We are changing the configuration to change the input voltage, but the output of this circuit will remain same. Either we are using at 110 volt or either we are using at 220 volt. The voltage at DC rail will same. The next circuit, that is our converter circuit, SMPS circuit, that will work same as it was working in this configuration. Just only we changed the configuration of the bridge rectifier, and we replaced this MOV. Here it is using 510 volt MOV, that is the original one. In the second stage, for the safety, it was using 240 volt, but here I used 420 volt MOV, so that is in safe limit. If you will use 300-350 volt MOV, that will work. So this was available with me, so it is good to use 420 volt range. Why they are using 240 volt MOV? Because it was protection for 110 volt power supply, that by mistake, if someone will enter 220 volt this MOV, it have range, the last MOV 240 volt plus minus 10%. It was 241K, 240 volt plus minus 10%, so that will damage at 215 volt. If someone will enter 220 volt, that MOV will damage. But while working on 220 volt, the voltage will increase 265 volt, that are normal. So 420 volt RMS, that is sufficient range. So that is the reason this was the available piece with me. So we can use 350 volt RMS to 450 volt RMS, that's the normal. If you are agree with my opinion that why I used this capacitor, please let me know in the comments. If you have some idea, if you have some opinion, please also mention in the comments. I will welcome. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.